On September 19th, two gray wolves arrive and appear to be marking the area surrounding the wildlife tree. A few days later, a bull moose comes in and checks out the tree. You have probably heard the term bear rub tree, but I've nicknamed them Twitter trees. Just as in our communication nowadays with tweets and Facebook, wildlife tweet using a scent-based service. Bears are the main followers of Twitter trees, and they tweet with enthusiasm. A few hours later, on the same day as the three bears had rubbed on the tree, some coyotes come along, and they aren't very impressed with the tweets the bears left behind. It's October 3rd, and there's snow on the ground, and a big old male grizzly comes and checks out the tree, and he appears to be in great health and ready for the denning period. Unlike the coyotes, this bear seems to really like the scents the other three bears left behind. It seems he starts reminiscing about the warm, lazy days of summer. Not only do the animals just rub on the tree, but they'll scrape and bite the tree as well. The next time you're in the woods, pay close attention and you just may find one of these wildlife rub trees.